Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon for your Amiga home computer. Only Amiga makes it possible. We are going west to go visit some orcs. Mountainous areas to the west. That's all it says. Sent there by the House of Healers. They're terrorizing the area or something like that. We have not been to the west. Horsey music. To the east is our home, and I think some mountains which are impassable. And then to the north is that desert, which we've been to and have not passed. So, oh, there's another bridge here. See, we have not been this way at all. Oh. Well, it ends. Okay. Then that would make it not a bridge, but rather a pier or a dock. Really? That's impassable to us. That's an interesting tree, isn't it? Should we look at it? It looks significant, just can't... Yeah, okay. So are these, like, fields? Like, crops or something here? I guess so. What if we ride the horse over the crops? Trampling your crops. Okay. There's more crops. We literally can't pass that way. Probably if we got off the horse, we could. But I don't see a need to go that way, right? Wow, really? Alright, let's get out of here. So here is... Doesn't that look significant? Wait. I'm supposing I'd... Could you see it from the horse? Just making sure. That looks significant, didn't it? You can ride over it, okay. Lava? Really? Okay, these are mountains. I don't know how much further we should be going away from where- Oh! As you start to go around the volcano, you suddenly hear the voice of an orc. Well, that would be it. Those bright winged beings have to be here somewhere. You heard it yourself during the torture session that there were more of them. You three search through the cave. The others come looking outside with me. Then a few orcs come towards you. When they see you, they grab their weapons and rush at you. So we just automatically jumped off our horse. So we have Orc, Orc, and Orc Chief. I wonder how tough these guys are. So these are the Orcs that were torturing the pixies, were they? Get my notes really quick. Fairies? Cave west of Spannenberg, where pond lies at foot of small volcano, took chain of office. Lady Heidi's chain of office, I guess, or the Baron's chain of office. In tree next to cave entrance? Question mark. Okay. Cave northwest. Of fields. Took fairy, broke wings. Oh, orcs. Oh, that's part of it. Let me draw a line because that's the same. I thought it was two different notes. One right after the other, but that's the same thing. Alright, let's attack these guys and hope that this guy doesn't kill us from range. He is shooting a longbow. What does it say about a magical aura? Orc cannot penetrate the magical aura. Oh, is that what I had on? I have something on. Didn't I? Sun helmet? Wait. I have something that helps. Magical sun. Oh, that's not it. Maybe it's on Egil. Mother of Pearl chain. That's speed. You know, I'm not completely sure. A compass that we're gonna try to fix at some point. Maybe it's part of Firebrand. I'm not sure. I thought it was something that I got. I've forgotten. Anyway, let's just keep attacking. Failed. The sling. He used his last ammunition. We're doing okay so far. What's say about a weapon? We said our weapon was broken or something. Orc has dropped a weapon. That's what it said. These messages fly by so quickly. Yeah, Orc cannot penetrate the magical aura. Still working on these guys. Ow, 6 points. Oof. Okay, since I'm failing most of the time anyway. I think these heal like 2 hit points. But I don't want to use up my good ones. So he has 34 right now. Let me just see how much we heal. 10 points, my god. So 24. 20. Is it attacking him? 23. 29. So I think it healed 6 points of damage, unless... No, because... That wasn't on me. I'm still undamaged. That's not bad, 6 points. Alright, I'm gonna keep healing him with that one. So I'm glad it's does better than just, like, 2 points. It probably has to do with your level. He's level 5? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's your level plus 1 or something. It's probably a random number 2, though. It's like a random roll. So, Wound potion. New to keep him alive. If he gets too low, I'll start using one of my better potions. Because we also have 3, 4. We have poison. Get these key. I forget what it is that's helping me. It's been a little while since I played. I think it was a skill that was taught me? I'm not sure. I have a feeling it has something to do with the bandit caves. 6 points. Yeah, it's like minor things I'm protected by. So I healed him, I guess. Yeah. I'm gonna keep going with that. Seem to be fulfilling. Well, not my old role as healer, but my grandmother's role as healer from Amber Star. Yes, let's use this. Potion 1. Boop. Just get 35. Nice. These orcs are tough. 6 points. So what, 29 now? He's 35. See, he's getting back 6 points every time, at least the two that I've looked at. So we're holding our own right now. Just this is our last healing potion 1. 8 points. Poof! One orc gone, finally. Agile 40 and a 64. Now we can't advance because this guy's in our way. Agile will now move around to help me out, and I'll go back to attacking. Agile moves. Agile moves again. He is capable of locomotion. And slicing up orcs with a sword. Ow, 7 points. Now what is... Edgel has a healing potion on one. His 2 threes. And that's really it. I want to keep him swinging, though, that's the thing. Can I... I can't give this to me, right? I can. Nice, so I can keep him swinging. That's pretty sweet. For some reason I thought we couldn't do that. Alright, so heal Agile, who's now on this side. Five points. Alright, so now I have 3 and 4. Yeah, stinks though. I only have one of each, and he has two of three. Yeah, what does this do? Remove panic. We don't have a whole lot of healing potions. Damn. Let's just wait till he gets down further, I guess, and I'll use one of those three potions. Maybe we'll find some more over here. It's gonna be about now. I don't know how much this heals. Let me... I mean, what if it heals, like... For example, like... 50 points of damage. That's way we're wasting some of it. Let him get down further, which is, I hate to do it. Eight points on that one. So 24. I'm attacking and doing no damage. Oh god, okay. 12 points, that's the worst hit yet, I'm pretty sure. He has 8 hit points. Oh! I might not act quickly enough. If we had another hit like that... That's not what I meant to do. Before I get to act... That's no good. May the gods guide my hand. 6 points. Failed. 1 point. Okay, good. Orc's axe is broken. Okay, so he's up to 39 now. Sauna way was that? I think it gave him about 30 points. Can we take down the orc? Nah. Too much failing. Orc Chief, use the last of an ammunition. Advance! Orc, drop the weapon. I see that, but then he picks it up, doesn't he? I'm kind of curious if I should be focusing on... I'm a sitting duck, but you know what? I have a lot of hit points, and Edgel does not. Do I have, like, a defense 19? His is 20, so I'm almost as good defense as he is. Let's see how we fare, because the Orc Chief is probably going to attack Citrine. Oh, he's attacking Egil still. Oh, damn it. I'm thinking about backing off Egil, really. What if we backed him off? Can he use that? Magical projectile? Is that a spell in the weapon? I think so. Well, I don't want to use it just yet either. So, can I? No. Hold up. That's not what I want to do. I want to. Can he use it? That's what I'm wondering. He can't even carry it. Well, he probably just can't carry all that, but maybe he can carry, like, a bunch. So if I give him an arrow, well, if I give him a bow, and 20 arrows, Egil has the wrong class to equip this item. He can't even use it. Never mind. That was a good idea. I mean, he's our damage dealer. I can barely hit the broadside of a barn. So if I back him off, I'm just basically being a meat shield and there's be nothing for me to do unless I want to heal up Egil until he gets back to the front line, but yeah, I might as well just heal him normally. So Egil, throw Citrine these Healing Potion 3s. Healing Potions 3, whatever. And she can heal you. While you now attack the Orc Chief. Gonna be a long ordeal, though. How long it took for us to just defeat one of the orcs. No damage. Other orc retreating. Failing. Wait. What happened? Well, you're attacking. Wasn't I healing you? Did I not do it? I didn't do it. Do the thing. Heal the guy, do the thing. Okay, the other orc's completely gone. It's fine. Okay, Agile's at 50. He's pretty close to full right now. He was already attacking. It's me that needs to attack. 6 points. Yeah, it's gonna be this entire episode, just this battle. And the little trek over here. Ow, 9 points on Egil. Egil did 9 points. Four points. 2 points. Another 2 points. Orc Chief is failing a lot. We approve. I actually did a point of damage on it. I'm so proud. 5 points, Agile, go! Get him! 5 points again! We're all whiffing. I did 2 points on it. You just hear these, like, swords go woof! Woof! Not hitting anything. There's a lot of air blowing around. Okay, Egil was attacked for... I missed the amount. He's at 39 points. Chief's battle axe is broken. We laugh at your misfortune. So what is he doing now? Punching him? We are slowly whittling him down by 2 and 1 point. He's retreating! No! Don't let him get away! Attack! Six points. Nice, Egil. After him! I don't know why he keeps resetting my attack. But not Egil. 7 points, Egil. Points. It's because he's moving away from me, that's why. So I'm reset to not attacking because my attack missed, he was no longer in front of me. I mean, I could keep doing that, I might just forget about it after all. 4 points. I wonder at what percentage of his health he is at when he starts retreating like that. Like, does he have 10 points, 10 hit points left? If so, this is going to take another 15 minutes. Not, probably not that long, but it feels like it. It's fun, though. I'm enjoying myself. I'm used to this with Amber Star. As your characters get higher in level, you're able to connect more often and hit for harder, which is always a good thing, gives you a sense of accomplishment and glad that you won't be so frustrated all the time. Alright, I'm just gonna have him attack. Gonna speed things up a little bit. Because I miss most of the time anyway. 2 points. One point. Another 1 point. I'm waiting for that one point that will kill it. 5. Nice. 140 experience points, 330 gold, 7 rations. Citrine has reached level 10. Now 69 dudes, life points, 6 or 7 power points, 16 training points. So I need to train in something. So it's probably going to be in another city. Alright, take the rations, take the gold. We have slings, we have an axe. We have ironclad leather. Hell bent for leather here. And a horned helm. And I could sell some. Oh, wow. Well, we can sell some of these things. There's the broken axe and battle axe. Yeah, we're really, yeah, weighed down with stuff. Let's just move this stuff in. I love that we can arrange our inventory now. Not like in Amberstar. Yeah. Locator device. And compass. I want to see if we can fix those somewhere. But you know what might be weighing us down? We have 725 gold here. Okay, so we have like 1550 gold. We could store some of that somewhere. And rations. Don't have that much. I'm pretty sure we have some more back at our house. Or at my house. But it's... You know, I've never heard this part of the song. Now we're back on our horse again, that's why that's playing. That's so funny. Alright, so we're gonna exit out, because... can't carry anymore, unless we start dropping gold, and I don't want to do that. Well, definitely gonna save. I said no, wait a second. A no to that. I guess we're starting here. A no, I don't want to load. Just doing great here. Here we go, 30. Yes. I want to try to rest to get his strength back. I guess there's some more orcs that way, which we're going to go that way. It's a lily pad or something. Hedgehog gains 26 points. Alright, it's dark. 11:30 at night. Shall we just rest some more? Resting would have no effect. Well, I want to rest to pass the time. Light a torch. Well, there's the cave. Can I walk over this? Can't pick those. I might be able to pick them with this. No. No. All right. Well, that was quite the orc battle. Stay tuned for next episode when we go inside this cave. We'll go see what the orcs have been doing to the poor little fairies or pixies or whatever the heck they are. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.